We cannot wait for this one. A near-capacity crowd of around 60,000 are flooding into the Emirates for Arsenal v Chelsea. It's the biggest game of the season that's already taught us to expect the unexpected.
The biggest WSL game of the season.
Can Chelsea smuggle it in? Yes, they can!
Emma Hayes will be leaving Chelsea women at the end of the season.
The Blackstones should win it and Arsenal have won it.
It's only the England and Arsenal captain playing with a BBC concert orchestra right there. Yes, Leah Williamson playing Still the One by Shania Twain. But will Chelsea still be the ones come May? Well, today will tell us a bit more about that. The champions visit their biggest rivals, who have won 8 in a row, and kick off here at the Emirates in just over 10 minutes' time. Okay, we are so glad you've put that Christmas shopping on hold for this one. And I'm glad you two have also. We are joined by Farah Williams and Rachel Brown-Finnis. Farah, when you think about fixtures at the start of the season, when you see those games, this is the one you're looking out for.
Most definitely, even as a fan, Alex. So as a player there, certainly if you play for one of those clubs, you look for that fixture, you know, the bragging rights of London, blue. But even as a fan outside of that, or a player that don't play for either of those teams, you still look for that fixture. Because you know it's always going to be an entertaining one, a competitive one. And as I said, those bragging rights in London.
Well, it's going to be a great game, isn't it, Rachel? First, the second. A lot of history and drama between these two teams. What are you expecting?
Well, it's you know, the successful old guard of Arsenal, you know, from the early 90s, when so many trophies went Arsenal's way and the tides have turned under Emma Hayes, and you know that success has been predominantly with Chelsea in recent years. What I expect today in the present moment is a highly competitive game. It's first against third. You know, Arsenal win today, as we can see, they can go second just on goal difference, level on points with Chelsea. And it's players who are back from international duty who are absolutely flying, and a couple of those we're going to highlight.
Okay, well, even though the heavens have opened on us here, it's not stopping. 58,000 expected to pack into the Emirates here. Let's give you some team news, because for Arsenal, Beth Mead, yes, that return continues, and she is in the starting lineup, having scored for England in midweek also. Vivian Miedema will be starting on the bench as she continues her return, and as you can see, Kim Little also in the starting lineup for Arsenal. For Chelsea, all eyes will be on this player right here, Lauren James, who has been in sparkling form for both club and country. Guru Wrighton, she does return from injury, but not quite enough to make it into the starting lineup. Also, Millie Bright not in the Chelsea lineup. Okay, Joe Curry has been speaking to both of the managers ahead of this one.
Jonas, two changes today from last time out in the WSL. What does it mean to have a fully fit Kim Little and Leah Valti back and available to you?
It's obviously great for the competition in the squad. It's great having quality players back that are ready to start games for us. It's not been an easy decision to take what's going to be the starting 11 today, because we have a lot of competition, but that's great problems to have.
Emma, Sam Kerr starts today after withdrawing from Australia over the international break. What sort of benefits did she get from not having to travel?
Well, I think people need to understand Sam played through the World Cup with a significant calf injury and came back injured and has been carrying that injury throughout, plus an issue within her foot. I mean, what she's done for club and country over the last 4 or 5 years is nothing short of remarkable, but her body couldn't withstand much more. So she's needed the time to get herself right because she hasn't been 100%.
Yeah, well, for Arsenal, only one win in nine in the WSL in the last games in this one. Farah, I suppose it comes down to the matchups, the individual battles, and you've picked out some interesting ones.
I think, you know, in terms of her development this season, if you have happened, if you want to watch two players, these are the two to watch in today's game. And this here, I think, when she gets the ball, she's very direct, goes 1v1 against defenders, and then has the ability into the top corner with ease. But not only does she score spectacular goals, she reads the situation. Here she is in the 6-yard box, you know, a very bad touch, but is able to readjust it. And then, obviously, this is the England-Scotland game, and, you know, her return such a long time out, and as much as her touch again isn't great, she's able to adjust it. I think it's the composure to just pass the ball into the top corner. It's fantastic, Brownie.
She's come back so sharp, albeit 12 months out of the game. To come back and to be so, so sharp and to still have the poise in tight areas to finish as she has done has been hugely impressive.
Yeah, I suppose today, though, stopping her, a defender who you've been really impressed with, Rachel.
She's matured so, so much, and Emma Hayes has been a huge part of her development. Started off as an attacking player, but really kind of cemented her place as a left back. Shows the speed. Here gets caught, got drawn towards the ball in a central area where didn't necessarily need to come into, but has the ability, we see here, to get back, get tight, not make a rash decision and dive in, but just muscle the player off the pitch. And this is the other side of what Neve Charles brings and what you need as an attacking fullback. Look at that for precision. Beautifully dinked ball to the back post to Sam Kerr for the easiest of finishes. And here, again, gets across a player, first time finish, and shows why she did used to be an attacker.
Yeah, really important player for Chelsea. She's started all the games so far this season, Rachel.
That's a first. She's been a bit of a utility player, slotted in at different positions for Emma Hayes previously. But yeah, she's become integral, and that left back position's up for graduate really at England as well as at Arsenal. At Chelsea.
We'll keep our eyes on that battle. Well, Beth Mead, well and truly back from her return from injury. Someone else also making a return is her teammate and partner, Vivian Miedema, who has also missed a year with an ACL injury. And when her Dutch team snatched away Team GB's Olympic hopes on Tuesday, it seemed like the perfect time to go along for a chat, and Joe Curry went to speak to her.
The Netherlands, 4-0 victors on the night. They go through to the semi-final.
Well, Viv, you're back at Arsenal after a busy international window. How awkward was that coming home and seeing Beth?
To be fair, I didn't come home till Thursday night, but I texted her after the game on Tuesday, and it took her about 3 hours to actually text me back. So, obviously gutted for Beth, like for her being back in the team, and obviously scoring a goal as well is amazing. But yeah, it's football. The highs and lows are so close to one another. But yeah, I am happy that we came out on top, to be fair.
Did the text at least say well done?
Yeah, well, my text did. I think she just texted back saying I'll text you later.
Now that you're back playing after nearly a year out with your ACL knee injury, was there one particular low moment when you thought, oh, this is awful?
The early 6-7 weeks after my surgery were just really, really tough. But then I also had to have like a second surgery in August again, which obviously once you've made progress, you don't want to go back into being in the gym again. It has been tough, but we're just really happy that we're back out there now.
Such a long time out. Is it tougher mentally or physically?
I would definitely say mentally. Eventually, again, like you start feeling better, you need to start trusting your body. And I think that's where the mental perspective comes into it. Like, how are you going to trust your body again? Like, Beth doesn't think. Beth just goes. And you could see that from minute one. Like, she trusted it, and it was really, really nice to see. Where I'm an overthinker, so everything that happened, I would just be, is this right? Is this normal? So I took a bit longer in that sense than she did, probably.
The fact that the ACL crew at Arsenal is such an impressive lineup of you and Beth and Leah and Laura as well, but does it get almost competitive because you are athletes, and do you push each other on perhaps quicker than you would have done if you were on your own?
Yeah, we are competitive. Like, I think throughout the process, we've all kind of helped each other. We've all pushed each other. We all want to beat each other, which obviously sometimes maybe isn't the best thing. We just need to focus on being back fit now, and the other girls on getting back fit, and go from there.
It sounds like a real team effort. Am I right in thinking that Kim Little actually came around and cooked for you as well?
She did actually, yeah. I mean, literally we've had all the girls over, they've been amazing after the surgeries. I must say though, they actually come over a lot more often now we've got a puppy than before.
Let's talk about this weekend then, this tiny little game against Chelsea.
Just a wee one.
Yeah, at the Emirates. If you win, you go level on points. If you lose, you go 6 points behind. How big an impact can this game have on the title race?
I mean, it's a big game. Like, obviously, hopefully in a sold-out Emirates. The Arsenal-Chelsea games are always really special to play in. And yeah, for us, obviously, we play at home. We want to beat Chelsea, especially in the league now with 22 games to just play for. Six points is a lot, so I think it's a must-win for us. The rivalry between us is obviously amazing, and I hope that, yeah, we come out of top.
Miedema saying it's a must-win game for Arsenal, Farah.
Yeah, and I'd have to agree. I think defeat to Chelsea today will see them 6 points behind Chelsea, and I think a difficult gap to close given the amount of games we play in a season.
OK, well, the first ever WSL match was a 1-0 win to Arsenal, beating Chelsea in that game. The scorer was Gilly Flaherty, who's alongside Robin Cowan today.
Thank you very much, Alex. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Emirates Stadium, the only place to be today. The biggest game in the WSL season so far. First versus second in front of a crowd of over 50,000 in North London. It doesn't get any better than this. A big occasion, the outcome enormously significant. Chelsea would open up a 6-point gap at the top with a win over their old rivals. A victory for Arsenal would see them draw level on points with the defending champions. It's two changes to the Arsenal side that beat West Ham before the break. Kim Little and Leah Valti return to the midfield. Steph Catley makes her 50th WSL appearance. Beth Mead scored twice against the Hammers and also got her first England goal in over a year against Scotland during the break. She's been involved in 11 goals against Chelsea during her WSL career. 8 goals and 3 assists. Chelsea also make 2 alterations from their win over Leicester. Shirka Muskin and Jessie Fleming come in for Frank Kirby and Sophie Ingle. Lauren James starts her career at Arsenal and has been in red-hot form recently. 12 goal involvements in 5 games for club and country. Sam Kerr missed international duty with a foot injury, but is fit enough to start. Chelsea are still without captain Millie Bright, but Gura Wrighton is named on the bench for the first time since October. Gilly Flaherty, a key battle you feel could have a huge influence on the outcome of this game.
Yeah, so obviously we've just been watching the warm-ups and it seems that Katie McCabe may be playing out of right-back, which we link in with potentially, as she's been put there, to mark Lauren James out of the game. But I think Katie McCabe, she drives the team on, she's a big team player, but if that is her job today, to keep that player quiet, it's a huge job and it's huge responsibility with the form that Lauren James is in. So I'm really hoping that that's a match-up, because I think it'll be a tasty one.
Jonas Eidevall beat Chelsea's Emma Hayes in his first game in charge of Arsenal on the first day of the new season back in September 2021. And that was in front of a crowd of just over 8,000. How far we have come in just 2 years. Rebecca Welsh in charge of this game. Red against blue, who will come out on top? Two sides in excellent form. Shaky start for Arsenal after they lost here to Liverpool on the opening day. But it is just one defeat in 12 in all competitions. Chelsea yet to be beaten so far this season in the league or in the Champions League. It's even the players are excited to get this one underway. In the rain in North London, here we go. Chelsea against Arsenal, always a huge matchup. Chelsea have got the better of the Gunners on recent occasion for the most part. They will be favourites going into this one, Gilly, you feel, but Arsenal's recent form will give them hope.
Yeah, I think Chelsea will naturally be going into its favourites, but I just, the thing about Arsenal when they play at the Emirates, I think the crowd is a huge bonus for them. I think they really drive them on, especially later on in the game. So, yeah, it'll be exciting. I hope it's an interesting game, and I hope it's a fun game with lots of goals for us to talk about.
We're giving it the big build-up. Kim Little on the front foot and drawing a foul from Erin Cuthbert. I think if that had happened a little bit later on in the game, it would have been more than a foul for Cuthbert. A lot of these players on international duty. I'm sure they've been assessed and cleared to play and each other their own programmes to see how much they can play today. Arsenal starting well, but the flag is up, offside.
Talking about your point then about obviously the foul on Little, I think today's game is all going to be about your individual battles. You know, we spoke about Katie McCabe against Lauren James, you've seen Erin Cuthbert, she's not leaving Kim Little alone at all to begin with, and I think it's all about those individual battles, and ultimately who wins their one will set the tone for the rest of the game.
Two wins in 8 games against Chelsea for Jonas Eidevall. One here at the Emirates and one at Selhurst Park in the Continental Cup final last February. That was a significant one. First trophy under his charge. But Jonas Eidevall saying that he feels that Chelsea looking stronger than ever.
I just think with Chelsea, they've got so much depth. You know, you can't really anticipate who's the whole starting 11 is going to be because of the players that she has and the changes that she can make.
There's Carter. On to Neve Charles. Now James. Fizzing ball from Mielda, who's forced to pump it forward and give possession back to Arsenal. Hatley under pressure. Works it back to Zinsberger. Crossfield ball, which is well anticipated by McCabe, who's got a lot of time and space to run into, and options in the middle. Here's Little, delightful! Mead couldn't quite get the shot away in time. Really good defensive action there from Neve Charles. James set away, trying to find Sam Kerr. Flag is going to go up against Kurt.
Just going back to that individual matchup that we just said of Katie McCabe and Lauren James. Initially, Lauren James doesn't track Katie McCabe, you know, and that's the thing of, yeah, she's not gone with her, but the danger is then when it's out of possession and Arsenal out of position, Lauren James is standing in that space. But, I mean, it's a great touch on the ball there by Neve Charles, but you're looking straight away, the ball from Berger into Lauren James, who's sitting in that pocket that Katie McCabe has left. But it's an interesting one because if one don't track, then the other one's free to do what they want, really.
Clearly, McCabe in the more defensive position, but she likes to fly forward. Hammered into Sam Kerr. Rested over the international break. Didn't appear for Australia. Their double bill against Canada, neither of which they won. Here is Nuskin. Carter on to Charles. Kim Little's starting position is slightly further forward than we're used to.
Yeah, and I think that's what Arsenal are wanting as well, is a player like Kim Little to be picking the ball up. No, she's playing just behind really Russo, which is a lot harder than what we've seen her play before this season. But I think she's got great skill, and if she can be that player to make them passes into Russo and to link up.
Well, track back from Beth Mead. Ford can't collect, but spread out to the far side, and Catley will take her time over this. Slightly more energetic start from the Gunners, but as we've seen time and time again, Chelsea can look sluggish and then suddenly pounce. Russo tries to do just that up against Jess Carter, putting her under a lot of pressure. Russo gets there. Out of play for a goal kick, but excellent work from Russo.
Yeah, really good work from Russo as well. Kate McCabe receives the ball the other side of Lauren James. But here, Russo just doesn't give up. She doesn't give up. I mean, I'm going to say from a defender's point of view, I probably would be calling that for the VFL. But I also think now you've got to be careful because you're not necessarily going to get given that. You know, it doesn't seem like there's too much of a pull there from Russo. So I think it's a fair one, but it's a one to be cautious of.
McCabe fires forward once again, those two up against each other. Russo trying to put Carter under pressure. That's well won. Get the flick on, anticipated by Ruben Moy. Here's Ford. Ruben Moy providing the angle. Good idea, just not quite executed to perfection. Mead making a really good run.
Yeah, you can see what Woman Way was doing there, and it's good from her because she stepped in. You know, she stepped into sort of the midfield area. It's a great run from Beth Mead, but it's just too, she got too much on it there, so it overruns.
Kerr patrols well. Concentration from McKay, but ricochets. Here's Kerr. And Arsenal defending diligently. Valti brings it away, plays a lovely ball over the top to set Caitlin Ford away. And Arsenal break on the counter. Ford striding forward into a good position, tried to thread it through for Russo. Mead! Is there an effort? Yes, there is! There's more than that! There's a goal! Beth Mead fires Arsenal into the lead! The Emirates against Chelsea. It's Beth Mead, comes up clutch, 1-0 to Arsenal.
I tell you what an absolutely incredible atmosphere here. Caitlin Ford, she picks the ball up, she drives, and that's what she does so well. She drives inside. We spoke about Kim Little being higher. Her being higher means she can afford to be in that position there, but you're thinking Beth Mead's going to pull it. She cuts inside. She smashes it into the roof of the net. You can't say that was a deserved run by Arsenal, but such composure in that area there. The amount of bodies that are on the line too for her to put it above them. But what an incredible atmosphere from the home crowd.
What a long journey it's been back for Beth Mead. And she is showing no sign that she's suffering still. Fleming tries to strike straight back for Chelsea, forcing Zinsberger into a good save.
I tell you what though, we've got to speak about Pelova there. The way she's able to control that ball, to turn back inside too, and to set Mead up perfectly. Yes, yeah, it's a big save. It is a big save. Especially when you are vulnerable after scoring a goal.
Not a bad corner either, but this is where Arsenal are so, so dangerous and ruthless, so they can be. Chelsea stopped them at source, though. Mead just took a little bit too much time to release the ball on that occasion. But no matter where your allegiance lies, when you see a player recovering from an injury like Beth Mead's, you just hope and pray that they're still the player they once were, and signs that she's not been affected by that at all. Two goals in the last game against West Ham, a goal against Scotland for England, and another here at the Emirates.
Yeah, no, that's huge for Arsenal and for Beth. You know, I think when you see a player like her mentality, the will to fight back, you know, the will to fight back and try and get back into the World Cup squad in time, there was no moping about, there was no feeling sorry for herself. And for Arsenal, it's like a brand new signing's come back because, yeah, she's so big for him. She's a huge player for them.
Vivian Miedemar and Leah Williamson to come back as well. Chelsea defend that well with Mielder. half but closed down so quickly that the pass goes straight to Katie McCabe, picking up a midfield position. Hatley too strong. Pullover attempting something that none of her teammates were expecting.
Yeah, it's just trying not to force that last final ball, you know, and I think with Beth Mead coming inside, you're hoping that there's a lot of space left wide, but for then McCabe to join in potentially and open up that space. But yeah, just don't force the final ball.
Still lots of time to go in this game, and Emma Hayes, more than anyone, usually knows how to sort these things out. Alessia Russo wins the header, but doesn't win the foot race with Jess Carter. Started every single WSL game this season, Alessia Russo. Two WSL goals, including a last-minute winner here against Aston Villa. Lauren James crowded out. Mead tried to set Pullover down the flank, out of play. Well, we thought Mead perhaps had overcooked this. Quite a few touches, but she knew exactly what she was doing.
Yeah, I thought initially Pullover was going to have a go, but I think here setting it off, Mead then just sells them all, really. Four players all go one way. She cuts back inside, and to have that composure as well, just pass the ball into the top roof of the net.
Mead said her left foot is usually just for standing on. I'm not sure if that's true anymore. Great goal against West Ham with her left. Another one today. Muskin helps it on. A bit of space here for Fleming. No one in the Arsenal midfield to stop her. Ball charging back, but she pops it off to Kanarid, trying to cut inside. Kanarid! In at the near post! And Chelsea are level! Skidded across the turf to beat Zinsberger. Just the response that Chelsea required. 1-1.
I think it's poor defensively from Arsenal because they had the bodies behind the ball. You know, Vitin Kanu travels with the ball, but they're set behind. You know, looking obviously, they've got the turnover there. Chelsea have done really well to get out of that. But you've got three defensive players there. Kathleen, she needs to go tighter. As soon as she cuts aside, you can't allow that space still. The question, obviously, Sam Kerr, is she blocking Zinsberger? But again, there's not really seem to be much argument from her or the other players. But here, I think with Britton Cannon, as soon as she comes inside, you've got to close that gap. You've got to get tighter so she can't pull the trigger. Yeah, you do question, I think, whether Sam Kerr does block Zinsberger view as she runs across her.
Timing of 13 minutes before I mentioned the three-letter word that we don't want to, VAR, but I think in the Premier League that would have been ruled out. Enough in the goalkeeper's eye line, I think. That is just a guess, I don't know for sure, but just from the evidence we've seen so far. But as you said, no one really complained, and we don't have it, so Arsenal have to get on with it. Kerr caught after she released the ball by Ruben Moy. Free kick for Chelsea.
I think it's one of them ones, though, where if we was able to slow it down, look from all angles, then you could question whether she did block it or not. But you're seeing now the challenges are starting to come in. Players just leaving something on the opposition players, especially with the weather, how it is, the surface is going to be slippy.
Charles. Chelsea regained their composure quickly after conceding. Good traits that they've fostered over a good few years under Emma Hayes. Mead, great touch. Takes out Carter, plays it into Ford. Takes a few touches to control. Ford trying to work the opening. Little forces Ford a little wide. Still promising position for Arsenal. Pullover to Caitlin Ford. Perisse tracking back, the goal kick. Some very crisp build-up play from Arsenal. But this is the goal that has equalised for Chelsea.
I mean, obviously, Ritten Cannon does really well here. She cuts inside, but I think, yeah, from this, from what we're looking at now, for me, I do think Zinsberger's view is blocked. But again, she still has to do so much here. You know, I do think Catlier, as she takes that touch in, take your step forward. Don't keep dropping off. Take your step forward to her. Don't allow her the time and space to shoot.
Alessia Russo through, but yes, she did look offside. Straight at Berger anyway. Arsenal having a lot of joy, especially down this right-hand side. Beth Mead causing problems.
I think Arsenal just sitting in the pockets. You know, they're sitting in between lines. I mean, yeah, she is clearly offside there. Just needs to hold her run though, Russo, because she could probably beat Jess Carter if she's in line with her.
Kurt. Strong, wins the header, but is pulled up for it. Wayward pass, told to calm down. Casey McCabe.
I think what you're looking at as well, if you look on the Arsenal's right hand side with Mead and McCabe, in that instance, then Mead's dropped off and Neve Charles hasn't gone with her. So then the pass is to Beth Mead, not the one over the top that Illicet tried to do.
Aggressive Arsenal pressing from the front, forcing the mistake. Russo. Sharp movement. Lovely ball. Kalova slips it through for Little. Brilliant defending. Perisse tracking forward all the way. But Perisse, and she's still battling for it. Alessia Russo too. Again, standing strong. Tremendous defensive work from Perisse.
Yeah, her positioning there was crucial, because if she don't track back there and she don't recover, Russo's free at the back post. Good combination play from Arsenal. What a ball by Kim Little, by the way. You can see what she's trying to do, but Claire was saying she has to stay switched on.
That was a tap-in, had Perisse not intervened. Well, that's gifted to Sam Kerr. She's a little isolated. She doesn't have it for long. Russo to Pelova. Wouldn't quite sit for her. Nuskin puts a foot out. Here's James. Runs it out of play.
You can see that battle between McCabe and James already. For me, I think Kate McCabe's just edging it a little bit.
At the moment, I'm sure there'll
be... At the moment. That's the key words there, Robin, at the moment.
Much more to come between those two, you expect. Stett with the header. Oh, that was a big challenge from Cuthbert, but no foul. Kim Little gets to her feet. Two Scots happy with that.
I was waiting for Kim to jump up then and sort of react, but I don't know if she saw it was there and thought, oh, I'll just leave her.
Switch, nicely done. Hammerid onto Fleming, back to Hammerid, and now Kerr. Slick play from Chelsea. Fleming. Now James. Chelsea last lost in the WSL back in March at Manchester City. Foul. And a free kick for Arsenal.
he's good combination play there from Chelsea, but sometimes with the passes that they make, they're not moving anywhere. You know, you're literally just passing along the same line when really you've broken Arsenal's press. So now it's about being more on the front foot and going at them rather than potentially just going sideways.
Well, Cuthbert got the ball. She also got Kim Little, but both happy to play on. Ford. To her. Perisay manages to turn away, but cleared by Kanarid. Such a tricky customer, Caitlin Ford.
Yeah, she can go on the outside, she can come inside. She's a real big game player for Arsenal, and I don't think she probably gets mentioned enough, but she creates so much for them.
Over, turning away from Cuthbert. Still going. Pelova. Again, Perisay in a really good position to clear that up. Ford fancying a run against Perisay. Down she goes. And yes, it is a foul. Free kick in a good position.
And I think that's what she does really well as well. She draws fouls. I think because she's just so direct when she gets the ball. She dribbles one way, she cuts back out the other way. She's able to draw the fouls.
We'll see what Arsenal can do from this set piece. Strange stats from this season. Arsenal have yet to score from a header. Chelsea have yet to concede from one.
Is this going to be the commentator's curse, do you reckon? You've set it up now.
I'm teeing it up there. Usually doesn't come off as easily as that. Whipped in. Kept in by McCabe. Cleared by Maren Bjelder. Arsenal look so dangerous going forward, but they do look slightly fragile on the transition.
I think it's where they're committing so many bodies forward as well. Just that's when you can potentially be so much more vulnerable, is on the transition. But that's the role then of the centre-backs, the holding midfielder, to make sure that you're switched on, especially to Sam Kerr, because I think for me, Sam Kerr's probably most dangerous when Chelsea aren't in possession because of the spaces that she picks up.
Good win from Illestet. Finds McCabe. Well, the crowd enjoyed that. Another incredibly consistent season and showing her quality again and again. Catley. Mead offering the support. In space. Cuts inside away from Charles and pokes it towards the 6-yard box. Well defended by Erin Cuthbert. Chelsea sitting deep. It's Ruben Moy with the fizzer. Arsenal in control in terms of possession. Chelsea have it back. The one-touch passing. Moving Arsenal around.
Go, guys!
Chelsea unbeaten this season, won every single game apart from draw against Manchester City earlier on. Foul by McCabe on James.
Lauren James, she's using her body really well there, gets across Katie McCabe. She's arguing that she's on the ball. I don't think she had any contact whatsoever on the ball there.
Not in the same postcode as the ball. Worth a try.
I might have to nick that one, that's a good one. Not the same postcode.
Carter sends it forward up towards Sam Kerr. So the depth in the air, McCabe closed down. Hurried clearance. Mishkin was battered from one side to the other.
Yeah, she just got sandwiched there, didn't she? But I think the foul is the Palova. She just sort of bangs into her. Here, look, you can see exactly what she's doing. She's not even looking at the ball, just looking at Mishkin there. A good call from the referee.
Dangerous looking one, way by Innistet. Fleming kept in acrobatically, but gifted to Beth Mead, who's prevented from making progress by Carter. Well played, Innistet. Nuskin dived in, Zinsberger will clear. Down the line towards Russo, out of play from Mielder.
Yeah, really good composure there from Arsenal. Because I think you see Beth Mead, she looked up. Potentially it was going to be a percentage ball, really, playing it forward. And there's a good chance it was going to turn back over. Goes back to Illestet, who then calm and casually, Gref turns Nuskin. But Arsenal really well to get themselves up the pitch.
Palova using her body well against Lauren James. Kept her quiet. But she could make a noise in the blink of an eye. Okay, beautiful ball over the top for Beth Mead. Charles nicks it off her, pumps it downfield. Swipe at Lauren James, enough for a foul.
Yeah, she does really well there. You know, not to the light of the crowd, but she does well there to win Chelsea a free kick. And it's hard when you're playing against Lauren James, it's hard to not get frustrated and leave your foot in, which, I mean, Beth Mead doesn't need to do that. She's facing her own goal, she's running backwards.
Some stern words, it seems, from Emma Hayes to Lauren James.
She's finger pointing as well, Emma, which isn't a very good sign. I
think that's bad, is it?
I've been on the end of a finger pointing. It's not a good look.
Zinsberger's first touch. Not great, but her second one's good, but it's surface a bit too zippy for Caitlin Ford. Out of play. First time to McCabe. See what she was trying to do. We'll get another chance here. Try and thread it forward. Over the top for Ford. Again, has Chelsea running back towards their own goal. Catley on the underlap. Nearly reaches Russo. Again, the last ditch defending this time from Cuthbert is crucial for Chelsea. Corner Arsenal.
Yeah, it's important there that Chelsea did recover. No, it's a great ball from Katie McCabe. She comes in on her left foot. Here, you can see what Catley on the overlap there. She cuts it back, but yeah, it's a great interception from Jess Carter there, as obviously Kim Little's coming onto it in the second phase.
Half an hour played, it is whizzed by. Here comes the corner. Good distance on that from Berger. Looks like she might have been knocked in the process of that. Arsenal still have possession. Kim Little. penalty. Manages to sweep it out to the far side. Aims for a handball on Perisay. Russo to pick it up. Out to turn. Here's McCabe. Now on to Ford. Fancies a run at Neve Charles this time. Ford delivers. Carter in the way. Takes a little too much time to clear that one. Arsenal keeping Chelsea fenced in. Lovely turn from Pullover. Mead. Ball cut out by Neve Charles. Kim Little couldn't control. And the referee stopped it for a head injury on the edge of the box. Kim Little just dusts herself off and gets up.
Yeah, I did think initially she was calling it for Cuthbert coming in steaming behind Kim Little, but then obviously she had her hands to her head to show that it was actually for the head injury here. Yeah, obviously she... I mean, they're both going for the ball, but initially that's what I thought it was going to be for that. But I'm not too sure. It seems to be Kim connects really with her shoulder, but... Obviously, I think when it's in that situation, you don't know whether it's the head or not. You have to take precaution.
Well, Emma Hayes is far from happy, it seems, and especially with Chelsea's number 10. Fingers are out, Jenny.
I'm trying to lip read, but I'm not good at that, so I can't tell you what she said, but... I don't know whether she's telling Lauren James maybe to stay higher up the pitch. It's a difficult one.
So Nuskin receiving some treatment. A reminder of what's to come on the BBC, the Women's Football Show. All the highlights from all the games in the WSL and more tonight, 11:45 on BBC One. And our next live offering for you from the Women's Super League. It's a big one tomorrow. Next Sunday, I should say. Midday, we start on BBC Two. Manchester United against Liverpool. Nuskin marched off the field. Arsenal have the... record for WSL crowds on the opening day against Liverpool, 54,115. We'll have to wait and see if that's going to be broken today. Really big push for tickets. Seem to be doing all the right things in terms of attracting crowds to the Emirates and to Boreham Wood, which they sell out pretty much consistently now, Arsenal. They are the standard bearer now.
Yeah, most definitely. And I think when the game's on TV as well and the weather is not that great, to still have a huge turnout, that's brilliant for women's football and for Arsenal as well.
Fleming, low on options, forced back. Mjelde has to clear in a hurry. It's been the story of the game. Can Arsenal keep this up though? Can they keep those sort of mistakes down to a minimum, losing it in dangerous areas? Pullover. Does really well to win it back and keep calm as well, pick the right pass. Harrison takes a tumble. Play on, says the referee. Here's Little. Ford. Owen. Headed away, and for another corner, Neve Charles had to get that right.
Yeah, it's one of those ones when a defender, you're running back to the goal, the ball's been zinged across the box. You've got to get something on it. You're not too sure where it's going to go, but she had to do the touch as well because Mead was behind her.
Hatley delivers. It's there! Amanda Innerstedt! Arsenal back in front! Prolific with her head at the World Cup. She's shown why there.
It's a great ball in. Here she peels off. It's just Carter who's marking her. For me, I don't think Berger needs to come out that far at all. There's no need to. Let your defenders defend. If she stays in her line and doesn't come for that ball, Innocent's going to pass the ball straight into Berger. She does not need to commit there.
She is such a threat, Amanda Illestet. So close to the golden boots at the World Cup with her four-headed goals. If there was a golden bunt, she would have taken it. I've got to say, questioning the goalkeeper will be great to hear what Rachel Brown finishes. Thinks of that. It was a great delivery, you've got to say.
Yeah, don't come for me, GK Union, just because I said that. But I just think, for me, let your defenders defend. Unless you know that you can fully come for that and you're going to go through everybody to connect with that, you need to stay, because she's nowhere near it. It's different, I think, if she's gone for it and she's close to winning it and she's now to put her off or whatever, and then it goes in. But I just think you're making that commitment, you're steaming out, and you're nowhere near.
Alessia Russo in behind, it's Russo! 3-1! In the blink of an eye, Arsenal have daylight! And Alessia Russo has another goal at the Emirates! The Gunners firing shots here against the champions.
We've only just stopped summarising the goal before. I mean, it's good patient build-up from Arsenal. For me, she's onside. I think she's just narrowly onside, but here, she's got one thing on her mind. You know, she plays off of Mary Mielder. She does really well to finish there, but, you know, you've seen that a couple of times before, Russo, and the goalkeeper's made a save, but for me, it's class, passing it into the back of the net.
World-class finish from Alessia Russo. Nice two-goal cushion for Arsenal now. They will not rest on their laurels. They know what the Chelsea team can do. But uncharacteristic errors, uncharacteristic hesitancy in defence. And Arsenal come forward once again. Berger's come a long way. Oh, and then she kept that outside the box. Now the flag has gone up, I think, for offside anyway, but that was another nervy moment for Chelsea.
Yeah, I think everyone was holding their breath there. I know I certainly was. When you see her sliding and it looks like she's not going to stop. If that's just the surface, the walk on the surface, you know, she does really well, I think, to try and keep it in. But like I said, it's offside anyway, so it would have counted, but she does really well to keep that in.
Lauren James hasn't had a sniff in this first half, but manages to work the space and get the cross in, away by McCabe. Neve Charles trying to put the pressure on. Beth Mead goes down. Applause from Jonas Edervall. He is enjoying what he is seeing.
And I think it's important that Arsenal stay on the front foot. You know, you can't just sit back and, oh, it's great that we've got a 3-1 lead, because the game can change just like that. And especially with a team like Chelsea, you know, you can't write Chelsea off. So Arsenal have to stay on this momentum, stay on the front foot, and at least get into half-time with the score still like this.
Berger sends it upfield. Ruben Moy with the winner. Emma Hayes, I'm sure, will have some strong words for the dressing room, and I'm sure she'll also be up for making some changes. We've seen that before. Not afraid to make the decisions, the difficult ones. She is ruthless, that is why she is a winner.
I also think sometimes when I watch Chelsea play and they potentially don't have that great of a first half, I always worry for the opposition, because I feel like when Chelsea get in and they have a half-time with Emma, they come out a completely different team. So Arsenal are probably hoping that there ain't a half-time. Just play through, because you know that Chelsea are going to step it up a gear come the second half.
We've seen that so many times, but Arsenal have capitalised. One of the few teams that have, when Chelsea have been slightly off it. Free kick as we approach the final few minutes of the first half. Easily dealt with, but picked up by Cuthbert. James, away by McCabe. And the influence of the crowd also helping. You can see even just a block from Kim Little has drawn a big, loud cheer.
Yeah, they will be huge today for Arsenal. No, I think even scoring that first goal, I think the hairs on my arms stood up. They were electric, and they won't stop throughout the whole game.
Lauren James, doubled up on. Ford didn't get there, but Catley did. For those who haven't made it today, you are missing out. Perisay forward. Arsenal have been excellent, but Chelsea have been sloppy, haven't they?
Yeah, they've been sloppy in possession, you know, just forcing it. But I think Arsenal just been so on the front foot. You know, they've been pressing aggressively. They've had a lot of composure as well when they've had the ball. But yeah, it's just not clicking at the moment for Chelsea.
Valti manages to poke it past Erin Cuthbert. A little bit too much on that. So many times Arsenal have got Chelsea running towards their own goal, which is not where you want to be, I'm guessing, as a defender.
No, especially I think with the weather conditions how they are, you know, the balls, they're getting slid through.
James finds Kanarid into the final minute of the first half. Charles past McCabe. Need get something on that. There will be a little bit of stoppage time at the end of the first half because of that injury earlier on to Nuskin. Here's Kanarit. Nuskin. Cuthbert! Kerr picks it up, finds James. Here's a step in the way. 5 minutes of time added on. Chelsea finishing the half strongly. Can they get one back here? Charles. And that's the keeper's ball.
You thought it was going to open up there for Erin Cuthbert, edge of the box. You know that she's got it in her locker to put that in. Again, it's just players just switching off to players running on their blind side. But here's Zinsberger, she's just got to get a connection on it because the way the ball moves, just parries it out wide enough, really. Because it could have been dangerous. She could have put that straight into Sam Kerr's path.
Good play from Kanarid. Alti clearing up with McCabe on the deck. McCabe caught after she'd released by Neve Charles. And a talking to from the referee.
Just a sign of frustration as well from Neve Charles. Obviously she's, it's hard, you're not going to win the ball there because of the way Katie McKay's position is. She's got herself in between Charles and the ball.
In a step forward, well won by Charles. Blows through for Sam Kerr. And now James. Catterit. Well played, McCabe. Arsenal forced to do a bit more defending during this period of stoppage time. Drop of the shoulder and good positioning.
I think Russo has done really well in the battle with Jess Carhart. It's a good matchup. They both know each other from country. But yeah, it's a good matchup. You see, they're both physical players. But I think Russo's doing really well to hold the ball up. Yeah, okay, she'd give that one away, but she's doing really well to hold the ball up and to bring others into play.
Great ball from Charles onto Canarid, but again, McCabe going about her business extremely well. Hasn't put a foot wrong so far. Balti. Charles dispossessed by Beth Mead, and that is very clever.
Yeah, really good play by Beth Mead there. Just draws the foul from me, Charles. One of those ones where you just... You're getting frustrated though, you just say to her, you don't need to do that. Beth Mead is facing her own goal, she's not going to go nowhere. Don't put your hands in her because it's 1-0-1. As soon as they feel that, they're naturally just going to go down.
Flick from Beth Mead. Russo doesn't play too much, but Carter putting up a bit of a blockade to stop her. 1 minute of time remaining. Cuthbert, not enough on that, has lost. Little brings it forward. Russo takes aim, Mjolda in the way of it. Wubbenmoy. McCabe stepping in and continuing her run. Mead. Really good run from Little. Just about time for the corner kick if Arsenal hurry.
Yeah, I think Katie McCabe again does really well to win the ball higher up. And I think that's the bonus of Kim Little playing higher up, she's able to make those runs in the box.
All eyes on Amanda Illestet again. Catley towards Illestet, and it's away by Charles. And there we have it. Half time at the Emirates, and it is all going extremely well for Arsenal. So far, so good. Beth Mead, Amanda Innerstedt and Alessia Russo with the goals for Arsenal. Canary did equalise for Chelsea. But Ginny Flaherty, a deserved Arsenal lead?
Yeah, I think so. I think Arsenal have been the better team in this first half. I think they've been on the front foot. I think they've been aggressive. And Chelsea have just been reacting second to everything. But like I said, I think Chelsea more dangerous in the second half when they're able to go in and have a chat, a firm chat from Emma Hayes. So I think the second half will be very interesting.
Well, a few discussions being had between the Chelsea players and the referee. I'm sure there'll be much more discussion in the Chelsea dressing room, because at half-time at the Emirates, it's Arsenal 3, Chelsea 1.
Thank you, Robin. Thank you, Gilly. Well, the 58,000 fans that have braved the weather to come to the Emirates today have not been disappointed. What a first half of action, Farrah Williams, we have seen.
Yeah, it's been a great game, certainly for the neutral. I think it's been, well, certainly that opening 20 minutes, it was end-to-end. But then I think Arsenal have taken control, certainly since the second goal. They've dominated possession, really controlling Chelsea's, you know, attack, and Chelsea really struggled to get out.
Why have they struggled to get out, do you think, Rachel?
Well, Arsenal were very, very clear in their intentions and how they played, and overloading down the right-hand side. But they've been so hard to get the ball off for a start. They've been careful. They've consciously thought about every single pass. Every single pass has mattered. Every single pass has had a bit of detail on it. And what I mean by that, it's not just been a short pass to you. It's been, right, where does she need? She need it on her right foot? She need it, like, what pace it's at? In real detail in the execution from Arsenal.
Yeah, well, it was a frantic start to the game, Farrah, and Arsenal really on the front foot, which led to their opening goal.
Yeah, they were, and it come down their left-hand side with Caitlin Ford, and I just think here, Chelsea's centre-halves here, you'll see Mielder and Jess Carter. I actually think they do really well in delaying, trying to allow defenders to recover. But Mielder has to put pressure on the ball a lot earlier, because what it does is allows for Arsenal to just overload, you know, Chelsea's box of players. And we spoke about this player, Mead, before the game, Beth Mead, about, you know, typical Beth Mead finishes. And this is what she does so well. She's just hovering out. You see her here at the far post, unmarked, shapes up to shoot, but just cuts in on her left foot. And we showed her, you know, exact goal like that before the game, Rachel.
I mean, she's a right-footed player, and she's talked previously about it being a weaker foot. I mean, the execution on this, because Mielder, although she doesn't quite get the pressure and doesn't get the contact to stop the goal, the experience of what Mielder does is to drop onto the line. She makes that goal pretty small. Mm-hmm. You see where Mead executes it, it's literally like, you know, a couple of feet above Mielder, below the crossbar. It's perfection.
Yeah, we talk about players coming back from ACL injuries, what form they might come back in, obviously the struggle, you've got that long time out. But Beth Mead's making it look easy right now.
I know, and I've never had a long-term injury like that to know what it feels like to come back, but she's certainly come back sharp. She's made an impact in each of the games she's come on in. The first game back here, 2 minutes on the pitch, setting up the, was it Russo's goal for the winner? So she's made a huge impact, and yeah, it is surprising, because you can come back from those injuries, though, certainly those long-term ones, with that little bit of hesitation and fear inside of you in case it happens again.
Yeah, well, where we're sat here at the Emirates, we are right next to the Chelsea dugout. And Rachel, you can hear Emma Hayes throughout that half shouting instructions, shouting to her players, wanting a reaction, and she got that straight away from her team.
She did. Overall, not a happy half for her team, absolutely. But the reaction, yes, they did indeed get. And you see here, the three players that they've highlighted, that overload down the right-hand side, the turnover possession, and it's really good play from Chelsea to slip the ball through to midfield. And Jessie Fleming eats up that space that we just highlighted there, slips it through to Rissen Kanarid, who puts it on her left foot and drills it near post. You know, in goal, goalkeeper is not expecting that to go near post, Zinsberger, but this is the conundrum, this is the dilemma. Is she in her eye line? Of course she's in her eye line, because Zinsberger, the Arsenal goalkeeper, has to take a position where she can see the ball. She steps to her right, can see they're clearly in the eye line of the ball. This time, a VAR or would-be VAR decision goes for Emma Hayes.
I'm arguing that wouldn't be in the eye line. I don't think she's in the eye line of the keeper there. Listen, I think the keeper can see it clearly enough. But I was going, if you go back to that goal, Alex,
yeah,
what Arsenal have done so well in this first half is that press.
Yeah.
And the first time Chelsea are able to break the press, they go on and get a goal from it. They haven't been able to do it other than that one chance that we've just seen there.
I love it when
of course, I'm Rachel was
she's a goalkeeper.
Right there.
If I'm a goalkeeper and they're in my eye line, they're a factor in my decision making. And if they're a factor in my decision making, they are interfering with
you know these new rules in football that never happen when Rachel Brown was a goalkeeper.
I'm taking control of it.
We're supposed to be a team here. Okay, right, we're going to carry on because then Arsenal back on the front foot again. Let's talk through 2-1. We always talk about set pieces being so huge, can win and lose your games, Bella.
Yeah, and I mean, it's a fantastic set piece. I think the goal, I think there's a goalkeeping error in that and you know, Rachel Brown. But I think this coming to build up to the goal, Alex, I think this is a foul here. Catley's giving away a foul, which then led to the corner. Emma Hayes was fuming in front of us. And then this is poor decision-making from the goalkeeper, in my opinion. But I'm not going to have the debate with Brownie because I know I'm right. She should never have come for this. She should allow her defenders to, you know, she pushed her defender out of the way to try and make contact. So that tells me she's already made a mistake in her approach to the ball. So for me, it's a goalkeeping error. Rachel, you can elaborate on my good analysis
good
there.
Yeah. Excellent. And I have to say, Rachel, I agree. The way that she actually, her first thought process, this is Berger, was to push the defender who's blocking her out of the way. You've already lost a fraction of a second. And that fraction of a second, if she'd have gone straight to the line of the ball, she probably would have got there.
Yeah.
But she's lost her concentration by dealing with that blocker player in front of her.
Rachel, when the team news came in, I remember you saying that was the first name on the team sheet you said to me. You said, Berger's in goal. Why were you shocked at that?
There's been, you know, a few sort of chip. Well, Mucevic had a brilliant tournament in the summer, and I know it's not a shock. For me, she's the big player. She's the big name for Chelsea. Always has been since she's come in. She's played, if she's not played every single match during the WSL, she's played in Champions League matches. So, but I was watching her warm up, and the last thing she did was run through set pieces, crosses in, and she didn't look comfortable. But, you know, whether it's decision or technique, a little bit of both on that.
OK, well, Arsenal going at half-time, 3-1 Farah. Still not a scoreline to be sitting on, but Alessia Russo, question marks over her goal scoring, but actually she spoke in the week about it's more than just scoring, her positions to pick up balls, but her execution on this one was fantastic.
I actually think she's had a fantastic season for Arsenal. I think she's certainly brought something different to their attacking style, but this, for me, is what Russo is so good at. When you get her running, making direct runs between the centre-half, she's very aggressive with her run and really, really difficult for any centre-half in the world to pick up. And then what she's really good at, Alex, is she can execute. And when she's in those areas, the composure to just pass it into the bottom corner was fantastic. And I think those type of finishes go underrated. And it was a clinical finish from Russo.
That's the way that she opens her body. She's on the left-hand side. You expect her to shoot, having to shoot with her left foot. She opens her body up but maintains a balance and the ability to then open that hip up and finish across the goalkeeper from that angle. Absolutely top class.
3-1 to Arsenal. This game is far from over.
Far from over because we know the quality of Chelsea and we know the ability of Emma Hayes to rally a team at half-time and to come out with a game plan that can absolutely pump Arsenal in the second half. So, yeah, Jonas Edvard better be ready in his team.
OK, well, yesterday, Manchester City were in action as they looked to face up to Chelsea at the top of the table. Their opponents were Aston Villa. Let's bring you the best of the action with Ben Andrews from that one.
Crosses in, and it's hooked all the way in. What a finish that is. Having repelled all that early City pressure, the away day specialists Aston Villa lead. And it is Dan Turner who's put them in front. Her first Villa goal in this division. And the shock is on. No chance for Keating. City, who almost never lose here, are behind. Broad, putting it on for Chloe Kelly, floating it over the top, and this time it is in, Lauren Hemp. They always score at home, and they have done here. The pressure finally tells. Kelly's corner, that's Greenwood, and Hemp's there again, and she scored again, and just like City have turned it round. Two from Hemp in 4 minutes. Villa led for nearly an hour. It's all gone. It's 2-1 City and Lauren Hemp's on a hat-trick. Hansen hassled out of it by Kasparaj. Kelly for Hemp again. Well, surely not. And Domsalar makes a good save. Could have been another City-headed goal. They've got more of them than anyone in the WSL.
Yes, Lauren Hemp making the difference in that one. Well, here's how the table stands at the moment. City right in the mix at the top there of the table. Villa down there in 10th. Makes for interesting reading, the table so far. Well, now, you would have seen at the top of the show if you joined us, Leah Williamson playing Shania Twain's You're Still the One with the BBC Orchestra. Really emotional stuff there. It's more than Farah, this piece, Leah, just playing the piano. She talked about how she needed that adrenaline, something to get her going, something that she's missed since she's been injured.
I think as athletes, when you're not out on the pitch and you go through these long-term injuries, as I said, I haven't had I've had a 4 month probably at longest, you're trying to find that buzz that you get from being out on the pitch and playing in front of the fans, etc. The fact that she's gone and been able to do that and play a piano in front of so many people is unbelievable, Alex. I wouldn't have been able to do anything other than play football.
It's brilliant to shift the focus of on really kind of driving to get that buzz, exactly what you mentioned there about performing, but in a field where you're not competent, yeah. You know, she was at the end, by the way, I wasn't dissing her skills on the piano.
Like you were.
She did an excellent job, but the nerves she'll have felt, the butterflies, the sort of jelly legs, everything about preparing to go onto that stage will be part of sort of the preparation and getting her back ready to be at a place like this.
Okay, well, you can see the full version of Leah playing the piano right there over on the BBC Sport website, and I can tell you it is well worth a watch. But onto the pitch, there's the Women's Football Show tonight at 11:45 on BBC One, and there's also highlights of the European Cross County Championships today at 5 o'clock on BBC Two. But right now, let's get over to Joe Curry, who has a former England goalkeeper with her right now.
Former England goalkeeper and Chelsea legend Carly Telford, who I imagine probably didn't enjoy that first half as much as the Arsenal fans did.
No, not at all. I think the first 20 minutes, once we managed to get that goal back, I was feeling a little bit more comfortable. But yeah, Arsenal have been by far the much better team. I think I've counter-attacked really well and scored some really good goals in a very good set piece. So yeah, we've got a lot to do second half.
So Chelsea performance aside, when you look around the stadium, pretty much full, how much do the players enjoy these big games at these big stadiums?
Well, clearly you can see Arsenal thriving off it. You get the crowd involved, as you can hear a majority, so we know how much a crowd can affect a game. I think it's fantastic what Arsenal have been doing, and everyone's kind of playing catch-up. We know we've got a lot of work to do at Chelsea to get more crowds at our games, but yeah, Arsenal have set the bar, and it's amazing to see so many young fans here, so many families. It's a great occasion. I just hope that we can kind of turn it around second half.
Because Chelsea have a lot of games coming up on the bridge over the next few months as well. The club are really trying to get the women's team selling out those stadiums, aren't they?
Yeah, of course, and like you say, with the work that we do, we've got Man United in January, we've got Real Madrid in January as well, two huge games in Champions League and WSL, and then we'll play Arsenal in March. So hopefully it won't be a revenge fixture because we'll get 3 goals second half. But yeah, it'll be a really good fixture. So it's a really exciting few months for Chelsea. So hopefully we can get loads more fans down to games. It'll be really exciting.
Now that you've transitioned as a player to the commercials and partnerships department at Chelsea, we know how competitive it is on the pitch between Chelsea and Arsenal. How competitive is it off the pitch to sell out the stadium?
I think people will be really surprised. Like, it is competitive, but Amy, who works in ticket and hospitality, has been brilliant. She's been doing this for 2 years. That's why she's ahead everyone. Our ticket and hospitality have been doing it for 3 or 4 months. So we've got a lot of learnings, but Amy and the team here are really open to working together, because at the end of the day, if we're all selling out stadiums, that's the way the game's going to grow.
Just very quickly, second half, apart from wanting to see Chelsea score at least 3 goals, what else do you want to see from them?
I just think we need to be more compact, tighter in transition. I think we've given them a lot of opportunities in transition. Emma said before the game that's their strongest point. Tighter in defence and more attacking and clinical.
We'll let you get back to the warm drive box, Carly. Thanks so much.
Well, as last Christmas blares out around the Emirates, all the fans are in the festive spirit. Let's bring you the best of the action from the first half.
Welcome to Emirates Stadium, the only place to be today. The biggest game in the WSL season so far. Is there an effort? Yes, there is! Chelsea are level. It's there. Arsenal back in front. It's Rousseau. 3-1.
Well, the players are back out on the pitch. Let's get you back to our commentary team today. Julie Flaherty is alongside Robin Cowan.
Thank you, Alex. It looks like a triple change for Chelsea at the break to try and turn the tide. Ashley Lawrence, Khadisha Buchanan and Fran Kirby all coming on at the break. I mean, we thought she was going to take quite decisive action, Julie, and it seems that's exactly what she's done.
Yeah, most definitely. I mean, I think for me to be able to see a player like Fran Kirby come on, you know that she's a game changer, she's a match winner. But yeah, it's interesting, obviously, those changes have been made.
And two, it seems, in the back line. So Perisay, Mielda and Nuskin, the ones to make way. Nuskin did get a little knock in that first half. So Ashley Lawrence, you suspect, in for Perisay. Right back. Buchanan in for Mielda. And then Fran Kirby in for Nuskin. Perhaps Jessie Fleming dropping slightly deeper. We'll have to wait and see. But clearly not happy with that back line in particular, Julie.
Yeah, I mean, I thought Perisay, especially out of her and Mielda, had a good first half. I think maybe, though, with Lawrence, she might offer a bit more going forward, which I think is potentially the reason for that change. But I think it's always hard when you're a player and you get took off half-time. It's always a bit, you do take it on yourself, as in it's my fault that the score is how it is. It's a hard one to take, but it'll be interesting to see how these subs get involved into the game straight away.
It's Arsenal in pursuit straight away with McCabe, delivers. Ashley Lawrence with a good first touch to clear that away. I think you're probably right, Jilly, because with the scoreline as it is, Chelsea need goals.
Yeah, and I think that's the reason for that change, especially because I do think Lawrence will offer you a bit more going forward. Surprised with the Mielda for Buchanan, maybe potentially because of Russo and how she's been playing. So it'll be interesting to see how she plays this next 45.
It's Buchanan, not had a lot of game time this season, just her third WSL appearance. Only one as a starter. Kerr just about stretches enough to find Lauren James. Canarid, Catley in the way. Charles, Kirby making the run. Here's Buchanan. Ruben Moy sliding in. Let's say she has started the season exceptionally well, Lotta Ruben Moy. Carter clears up with Russo in hot pursuit. Balti.
Yeah, just talking about Ruben Moy, I think she's had a great start to the season. You're looking at that tackle that she had to time really well against Lauren James. I think she is a confidence player. You know, she had a difficult season last season, especially with the reason, obviously, when you look at the game that they got knocked out against Wolfsburg and the mistake that she made. But I've always said a player learns more from mistakes they make, especially like that in that game. So it's really good to see her performing the way she is.
Arsenal through and through, taking her opportunity. A referee happy with that. One by Catley. Here's Beth Mead opening up for Beth Mead. Really good challenge. Well timed from Buchanan. McCabe. Neat, tidy, incisive from Arsenal. Little continues her run. Here's Palova. Receives well. Easy take for Berger. Plover's really come into her own this season for Arsenal.
Yeah, no, I think she's had a great game so far. No, she's again a confidence player, giving her the opportunities to play. She offers something different to Arsenal's midfield than what they've already got. But no, I think she's had a brilliant game so far.
Kerr. Erin Cuthbert, over 200 appearances for Chelsea. James. Away from Balti, it's Lauren James! Just wide.
You can see Balti there as well. She's saying to her centre-backs, you need to come. When she's beaten midfield, you need to come and step out to her. But again, it's just Arsenal players just putting their foot in, half-hearted. But again, they're one of the centre-backs you have to go and steam out. You know what Lauren James can do on the edge of the box there. You can't afford to give her the time and space to open up like that.
I think it needs to be a lip reader to know what Emma Hayes said there, but understandable reaction. Just need to get her into the game. And that's not just on her teammates, it's on her as well, isn't it?
Yeah, most definitely. And I think, obviously, she knew early doors with Katie McCabe, she was going to be all over her and tightly marked. And then she floated over to the other side where McCabe isn't. She's come on to the opposite side. But with Lauren James, she's got the freedom to roam, really, wherever she wants to go. So it's about all players being on top of their game. But it's the ones where you see her when she drives in and players just put their toe in. Like, she should be better off just standing up and staying with her rather than just selling yourself, because that's what she wants players to do.
Steph Catley receiving treatment. Still teaming down. Wonder what Claire's having. It's her trademark Bovril. That might be slanderous, apologies. Ready to come back on, it seems. Here's Kerr. Catley now making her way back onto the pitch. She might be needed. Kirby. To play from Fleming. If you are Arsenal, how do you play this, Gilly? Because you have a two-goal cushion, but if Chelsea get one, then you start to get nervous, but you don't want to spend the whole half defending, do you?
No, you don't, because the deeper you get as well, the more you encourage Chelsea. So it's about really Arsenal doing what they've done in the first half, you know, being on the front foot, being aggressive, not allowing Chelsea to get into their stride. And it's just taking care of the ball, but using your brain as well when it comes to these situations. You know, managing the game, just see Katie McCabe there. She kicks the ball away, she smiles at the crowd. But I also think as well the crowd are going to be huge for them in the second half.
Get the impression that she's a sort of player who doesn't mind that bit of crowd interaction, shall we say, Katie McCabe?
Oh, she loves it.
Russo dispossessed. So oh, Ashley Lawrence just about got away with that one. Bringing it away under pressure from Ford. Russo trying to get the better of Buchanan. Needs down here. One of them slipping and sliding all over the place now.
Yeah, and I think as well that would be interesting with Buchanan and Russo, because they're both sort of, Buchanan's a player who wants to get nice and tight to the centre forward. She's not one who really stays off them. She gets nice and tight, but Russo's one of them ones who probably likes to feel where the centre back is, because so she can try and roll them and spin them. So yeah, I think that would be a good matchup in the second half.
Beautifully taken, Russo. Mead. Now McCabe. Mead, heavy challenge on Carter. And McCabe, though, pulled up for that one. A and a yellow card, it seems. Katie McCabe, I think that might have been, yes. I think she'd do well to calm herself down.
She's still going even after being shown the yellow. But I think as well, you're looking at the one with Carter just before that, with Mead. You know, both players went in and it was shoulder to shoulder. Here, obviously, it is. I think it's because Katie McCabe comes from behind. It looks like it's a push from behind, but she's just got to use her head there.
I don't think the yellow card was for that challenge.
No, it was for the aftermath.
And she's now got four yellow cards this season, so one more. She's already getting a ban. Obviously not something you want to take out of her, but slightly frustrating perhaps if you were the manager.
Yeah, and I think you don't want to take that away from her because that's what makes Katie McCabe the player that she is. But it's about, you know, you don't want Katie McCabe to get another yellow in another game and then have to miss out a game because she's such a big player for Arsenal. But also from an opposition point of view, once they know Katie McCabe's got a yellow, you can play on her because you know that she's going to be solid with her tackle and there's a risk that she could get sent off.
Challenge is flying in. The ricochet finds Catley. Now Caitlin Ford up against Ashley Lawrence. Canadian international, along with Khadisha Buchanan. Pelova. Catley couldn't quite take it under her possession.
It's frustrating because she was in acres of space there, in between the midfield and the defensive unit, completely unmarked.
Scored the only goal for Chelsea. Ooh, that wasn't a clever one from Caitlin Ford. Unsurprisingly, a yellow card for the Aussie.
They might also just need to keep their heads because they're not the team that's losing. You know, they're the team that's winning. It's obviously, she clearly thinks she can get there, but it's just got to be realistic. You're not going to win that ball. Just let her, she's running into Kim Little. Kim Little's literally standing there. Let her run into her.
This might force Jonas Edervall in some changes, perhaps. Chloe Lacasse on the bench. Possibility. And, of course, Vivian Miedemaert. Charles. Ashley Lawrence, finding Kerr, shaking off the challenge of Illestet. Now Kanarid, dangerous ball, well dealt with by Ruben Moy. Few appeals for a penalty. Frank Kirby taking a tumble off the ball. Kirby asking the question now.
Oh yeah, I mean she does step towards. She steps towards Fran Kirby there. You know, you say similar a little bit to Myla Tissier, her challenge against Aston Villa. I think that's the first game of the season. I'm surprised my memory can go back that far. But a bit similar because you're going towards the player and not really watching where the ball is.
Lovely ball over the top and Ford is in. Can she control? Played off the Mead. Tremendous block. Jess Carter.
Yeah, it's a big block from Carr, but it just didn't seem like the ball was rolling quick enough to Beth Mead. No, she had to sort of come onto it, but I think if Ford were able just to get a bit more on it, I think Beth Mead would have been through.
Ooh, a heavy challenge, but a fair one on Cuthbert. And space opening up once again here for Arsenal. Mead trying to flick out Arusso. Berger quick off her line.
Yeah, she had to be there. I know there was questions about whether Arusso was going to be offside or not. But the space there between the defenders, the Berger, that was good from her, on the front foot, able to sweep up behind.
Still a bit ragged, aren't they, in defence, Chelsea?
Yeah, defensive line is just all over the place, to be honest with you. Just watching it, Buchanan's playing a lot deeper than what Lawrence and Carter are, which then Russo's playing on Buchanan because she is the deeper one.
Those balls over the top.
Yeah, the space there. Because the space has opened up because Buchanan's been dragged in with Russo, whereas in the first half, Carter and Mielder were just allowing Russo to drop in deep and keep in their position. But Buchanan gets dragged in, which then opens up the space between Carter and Lawrence. But it's a big block from Carter. But I think if Ford can just get a little bit more on it, then Beth Mead's through.
Kim Little needing treatment now. This will be a concern for Arsenal. She missed a lot of the last season, the end of the season, with a hamstring injury. She's pretty much irreplaceable. Arsenal do try to find solutions, but an excellent performance again today. Frieda Mornham receiving instructions, getting ready, just in case Kim Little can't continue.
I think what's good about Kim Little is obviously she's, I think she actually might be a little bit older than me, but she's a player who uses that experience. You know, and the first sign that she feels something, I think sometimes with younger players, they have that urge to want to play on and potentially make injuries a lot worse. But that's what I love about Kim, is because as soon as she feels something, she's sensible, she sits down, and then she gets the physios in. She doesn't try and run on and try and play on. And I think that's just the experience and the maturity.
Yeah, Kim Little forced off. Hopefully it's just a case of no chances taken. The captain withdraws. There's still half an hour left to play. ...299th Arsenal appearance today. And Frieda Mornham, who has scored in each of her last three appearances for Arsenal, will come on in her place. Finds Kirby, then Canarid. A well-timed challenge from Catley, but she might have paid for that. Looks very, very uncomfortable, Steph Catley.
Yeah, it looks like she's pointing to a hip flexor, or just, I think she just takes that. If it's a knee, or that gets caught on the surface.
Quite a jolt there as she hit the surface. Looks like she's going to try and continue.
I think sometimes it's just the initial, it takes the wind out of you a little bit.
Cuthbert. Didn't get the curl on the cross, straight into the gloves of Zinsberger.
Yeah, calm hands there from Zinsberger. I mean, I don't think there was really any Chelsea players around her, but in the conditions that we've seen, it's important for her to be able to catch that.
Russo will try to turn back inside. Fouls Buchanan.
I think Kay McCabe got a little bit nervous then, because the referee blew as she kicked it away. So she was a little bit nervous in saying, "No, ref, I didn't mean that."
Oh. She wouldn't thank you for bringing that to our attention. Looks like Guru Wrighton is ready to come on for Chelsea. Well-timed challenge from Beth Mead and a corner kick for Chelsea.
Arsenal just need to make sure that they don't just keep dropping deeper and deeper and inviting Chelsea to bring more pressure onto them. They're defending it really well at the moment, but you know, you can only defend for so long.
Well, Aaron Cuthbert-Ridge take the corner, but before it's taken, Chelsea will make the change. Johanna Ruiting-Canaris. We've got Chelsea's equaliser is off and Guro Ruiting. They've managed to cope without her up till now. She's been out since October with an ankle injury. She could be the key to getting back into this game for Chelsea. Cuthbert swings it in. Ooh. Gratefully falls for Zinsberger, who sets Frieda Marnham away. Pullover powering up the field, and so is Caitlin Ford. Marnham tried to slip it through for Pullover. Well cut out by Kirby. One back by Mead. Here's Caitlin Ford. Options. She didn't pick the right one. Cut out, although Carter pulls Mead down. They both look at the referee. And the referee gives a corner kick.
Yeah, I think Beth Mead's wanting the penalty. Carter's wanting a goal kick. They both don't get what they want, and out comes a corner from it. But Arsenal looking dangerous on the attack. So we just sit there. I think it's just a tussle between them both. I don't think it's a penalty at all.
Corner. Well held, Berger. One by McCabe, on by Ruben Moy. Buchanan sends it out to Kerr. Infield to Frank Kirby. Shielded the ball well, drew the foul.
I think Arsenal players are just getting a little bit frustrated with the referee decisions. You know, you just have to play the game. You know, slight bit of contact.
Ooh, that was a close one. Very close, Lauren James.
Yeah, just sort of, I'm not too sure if it overrun there. See two players around a bit. It does seem to me Catley's looks to be struggling a little bit as well. Just watched her afterwards. When James is sitting down, she's just bending over, walking a little bit gingerly. So it'd be interesting to see if that's a potential change as well that's made.
Defended by Ilesteton, Sam Kerr. Russo. Trying to get away. Well played. That's what Jess Carter is good at. That 1v1. Chelsea usually so solid defensively. There have been some suggestions that they really are now starting to miss Millie Bright. They can cover themselves for the most part because of their quality. Marnham on Cuthbert, and it's a foul.
You just shake your head a little bit because it's just like it just does not need to happen. You know, when I used to play, I used to get really annoyed with my forwards. When they would foul, I'd just be like, there's literally no point. They're running back to goal. Just stand up. But it's very good from Erin because she wins her team an important free kick, but you just don't need to make that contact.
Quarter of the game remaining. Here's Ford. Marnham, Mead on the outside. Lovely layoff for Palova. Tracked by Frank Kirby. Digs it out, but it's picked up by Ford. Now Catley. Palova. James getting up ahead of Ruben Moy, unfairly, according to the referee.
Yeah, it seemed to be a little battle there. But I think that card, I don't think that card is for that initial one. I think she might have done something to Vaughty afterwards, which is, I think that's what the yellow card is for. I think it's an off-the-ball thing. I think here is the initial, but I think something happens here. Oh, she just steps on her foot. That's what we're talking about with Lauren James. Obviously, we see it in the World Cup. It's those things that you do off the ball where it's a frustration. You don't need to do that. You really don't.
Well, we have seen this thing before. We saw it in Australia. Petulance, just a yellow. There might be questions raised as to whether that could have been more.
There it is, because you're saying that's deliberate. It's not like it's accidental, that's deliberate. And you could have, I mean, she steps on her foot, but if that goes down her shin, you could have really hurt Vaughty. So just don't need to do it.
Kerr manages to somehow slip it through for James. Space opening up here. It's Fleming. So much space for Ashley Lawrence. Can she finish? Took too much time, and Arsenal clear. But how open were Arsenal there? What a chance for Chelsea, and they passed it up. Ford down the line for Russo to chase. But Lawrence lacks a bit of conviction there with the position she found herself in.
Yeah, but Steph Catley as well does really well, and the recovery from Arsenal players to get around Lawrence.
This is really messy from Chelsea. Mead up against Cuthbert.
You can hear the crowd, you know, you're getting behind Arsenal, the rain starting to come down again. Exciting.
We're cinematic here at the Emirates. Wrighton clears upfield towards Sam Kerr. Touch tight, Innistet. Arsenal have it back. Chelsea look a bit leggy. Palova onto Russo! Well, was she taken out by the keeper? Yes, she was. Penalty to Arsenal. Carter cleared up, she got the ball. She tripped over Berger. The goalkeeper couldn't do much about that, but Rebecca Welsh has pointed to the spot.
Yeah, it's one where obviously Carter's there, but Berger's committed too. It'd be interesting to see the replay of it as well. She's adamant it shouldn't be a penalty. It's one of them ones as well, though. I don't know why Berger's come out, because Jess Carter's there. Let Jess Carter defend that ball. She's first to it. You know, it's just there's just no need. It's so unnecessary. But if you're Jess Carter there and you see your goalkeeper, it's a hard one because obviously I was a centre-back. I'm going to go for that still. Yeah. But you have to be able to be close enough there to go through Jess Carter as well, or Jess Carter needs to hold back and let Berger come.
Kim Little, the regular penalty taker, is off the pitch, so Alessia Russo, who won it, will take responsibility. Chance to put Arsenal 4-1 up. Pressure moment for Alessia Russo. Absolutely clinical. Alessia Russo has her second. Arsenal surely from this position they will be taking the 3 points.
Yeah, huge composure there as well for Russo, considering Arsenal have missed their last 4 penalties. It's a big moment for her, for a young player as well, to take that responsibility on. It's a great finish into the bottom corner. The amount of power that's getting behind that, I don't even think if Berger could get a touch on it that she'd keep that out, because the power behind it, it's right in the bottom corner. But great composure and confidence there from Russo to step up.
And Katrin Berger went the right way, but it was just too far into the corner. And with that, a triple change coming up for Arsenal. Mia Fischel coming on for Chelsea. Alessia Russo's last kick of the game is to put Arsenal 4-1 up. For Lauren James off for Mia Fischel for Chelsea. Stina Blackstinius on for Alessia Russo. And Steph Catley withdrawn. Noel Maritz, the right back, will come on. And Catley's had a couple of knocks today. And Beth Mead, another step on the comeback trail. Chloe Lacasse on in her place. Well, 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 it's not very often you see Chelsea conceding 4 goals.
No, it's not often at all, but Arsenal have been, they've been clinical today. I think Chelsea defensively questioning Berger as well on a couple of those decisions. But Arsenal defended really well today, really well, because Chelsea have had their moments.
It could get worse for Chelsea now. Lacasse making her way down the field. And they have an overload on the far side. Blackstinius to Maritz. Pelova. McCabe. Desperate to have possession of the ball. That's given back to Chelsea cheaply from McCabe, Kirby, Fleming. Here's Lawrence. McCabe shuts the door on Ashley Lawrence. Brilliant defending, and then the foul. Terrific play from Katie McCabe.
Yeah, really good defending from McCabe, because when the initial block, you can see her, she's fighting so hard to not let that ball go out for a corner. She wins the first one, she wins the second one by the byline as well, and she just got that fight in her. No, that's what I've said about before the game, the fight that Katie McCabe has.
A WSL record attendance. It smashed the previous one. Just under 60,000 inside the Emirates on a wet, cold afternoon. But the Arsenal fans in particular will have no regrets about making their way out to this part of London today. And for the neutral, for the title race, this just really hots things up.
Yeah, I think it's good for our league. I think it's exciting, and obviously I play for both these clubs, but I think it's exciting that Arsenal potentially looking like they're going to pick up the points. And it just bridges that gap closer, and it makes it, it's just not one a one-horse race.
Here's Kirby. 12 minutes still to play. Kirby still going. Cross comes in. Side netting.
It's just been the decision making for Chelsea in the final third. The options, the support, movement off the ball. It's not been where Chelsea standards and normally are today.
And they might not even need it, Vivian Miedemar. Just slightly behind Beth Mead in her recovery for her ACL injury. I think from her perspective, she'll be desperate to get on.
Yeah, I reckon so as well. But if I'm a Chelsea point of view, I'm thinking you just don't need her to be brought on, do you really?
A golden couple of women's football. They've had to go through something pretty extraordinary together. Here's Kerr. Kirby. And to Cuthbert, turning away from Mornham. Maris. Leah Williamson, also TBC on her return. But if you saw at half-time, she's been learning the piano just to make us feel even more inadequate about what we're doing with our lives. Is there anything she can't do, Gilly?
I was going to say, hold on, I can play the keyboard. I can play the Rugrats theme tune.
Lovely stuff.
They are all in a row, though.
Maybe if a guest pulls out at half-time next time.
Maybe.
It's an option. Official trying to turn. Oh, that's loose. Picked up by Cuthbert. Kirby takes aim. Still 10 minutes to go. Arsenal don't want to get complacent.
I think you're there, though. You're just seeing the frustration there from Fran Kirby. No, she is a player that can pick the ball up on the edge of the box there and put it into the top corner, and there's no doubt about that.
Well, Emma Hayes' farewell tour was turning into a procession, but she's leaving for the USA at the end of the season with a defeat at the Emirates, and that is going to sting a lot. The rivalry built up with her former club, the one that she won everything with as an assistant to Vic Akers. Lawrence. Official. Fair challenge from Mornham, or no? Referee has pulled that back for a free kick to Chelsea.
Yeah, I think that was for the initial one at the start of that move there.
Vic Akers surveying the team that he founded and won everything with.
Yeah, Vic Akers was the man who gave me my first senior debut as well at 15, so I owe a lot to that man.
A yellow for Maritz for the obstruction. Just preventing Guerreiten getting into the penalty area.
Guerreiten does really well there because she draws Maritz out. She knows what she's going to do, she knows she's going to commit. Pass don't even really need to go to anyone because you've won the foul.
Options in the middle. It's another one that must really frustrate you as a centre half coming all the way up from the back.
I used to get my mum and dad used to shout in the crowd, get back, it take me an age to get back. But yeah, it is a frustrating one when you go all the way up there and that happens.
Ford on the charge, loses the ball, the pass with a swing and a miss. Arsenal beat Chelsea 5-0 at Boreham Wood a few seasons back in the season where they won the title. Wouldn't put it past them to score another, make it five. Chelsea have been loose. Lovely ball from Valti. But Mortnum flagged offside.
Yeah, I think frustrating there for Mortnum as well, because it looked like she could have really ripped that in for Blackstinius, who was standing in the middle of the six-yard area.
Yellow card given, possibly to Frieda Mortnum. Robin Moy.
She's been brilliant today with her composure on the ball. Not been full snitch, been picking players out.
Lacasse. Making up good ground. Illicet. Finds Blackstenius. The turn away from Carter, not finding it too easy to do so.
Yeah, Neve Charles there just does really well with her body. I think Jess Carter, I think she had a good game today. I think, you know, she's used her body really well. She's had a battle with whoever's been playing. I mean, you're looking across the line there, unsure whether Neve Charles potentially could be playing her on. But I think, yeah, the yellow card there is for kicking the ball away. Unnecessary.
Can't say they haven't been warned, so that's going to happen. Ford. Mortnum. Chelsea game cuts open. It's Blackstinius. Ooh. That's a miss. That's a big miss. Thankfully, don't think it's going to matter.
You could probably argue that potentially could have been the easiest chance that Arsenal have had. It's just that composure. I think you can see what she's trying to do. She's trying to like curl it into the top corner there. Just doesn't wrap her foot around it enough. Just goes embarrassingly wide for Blackstinius.
Scored in each of her last four games for Arsenal. Pelova brings down Erin Cuthbert. And a yellow for Victoria Pelova. Not strong enough. Illicet's done a job on her today. Not sure exactly how fit she is, Sam Kerr, but she did miss the international break with injury. She has played the whole game, but clearly not at her best today.
Man, I think both centre-packs have done really well to man mark her out the game.
Kirby pushes it onto Wrighton. Digs out the cross. Kerr got there, but again, well marked. Blackstinius trying to get away from Carter. Fleming. Kirby. Wrighton again towards Kerr, gets there. Punch from Zinsberger. Mortnum. Manages to release eventually. Pelova, great ball. Off goes Chloe Lacasse. Shoves over Neve Charles. Lacasse. To Ford. Blocked by Buchanan. Well, they could have had a hatful in this half.
Yeah, they had plenty more chances in this second half as well, but you could argue then as well, was that not a nip foul on Neve Charles? You know, I think the body-to-body, because of some of the decisions that have been made in the second half, but Claire Class is really well. Carl just stands her up. But again, I mean, you question whether she's offside, Ford. Yeah, she is. She is offside.
It's the final minute of normal time. Fischl.
I think that's what a lot of Chelsea's chances have resulted to this afternoon. You know, half-hearted chances, not really clear-cut. It's a good attempt, it's a good effort, but the conviction isn't there behind it, which is what I think you're not used to seeing from Chelsea, but it's what you've seen from Arsenal this afternoon.
Here's Cuthbert. Chelsea still plugging away. Kerr. Fleming. Trying to work the opening away by Illestet. Out of play. Well, unless something miraculous happens, we will ask Julie Flatty for your Barclays player for the match.
I was going to say, this is women's football, you know, anything can happen. But, yeah, I think for me, my player of the match is Russo. Now, Alessia, I think she's had a great game. She's obviously scored two goals, but her work that she's done off the ball has been huge for Arsenal today.
Lacasse. Turning away from Charles. Blackstenius. Just haven't really made the most of those, Arsenal. McCabe trips. Right, it's more than the goals that she gives.
Yeah, I think she just caused such a problem for the centre-back. You know, she's run the line, she's run the spaces. You know, she's been a centre-back's nightmare today, the way she holds the centre-backs, she turns, she spins. Again, a great finish for her goal, a goal full of confidence and composure. And then, like we said, Arsenal have missed the last four penalties. So step up on this stage in front of this crowd against Chelsea as well, which is a big game, to calmly put the ball into the back of the net. Yes, she's had a great game today.
Still time for more. The set-piece coach, Patrick Lindquist, directing. McCabe left-footed swings it in, nodded wide. Another chance for Stina Blackstenius.
Yeah, we're getting a great ball in from McCabe. Just Chelsea just getting the wrong side of the players, you know, they should be goal side, tracking the players into the box. Just seen that Arsenal want the ball more in those situations than Chelsea.
Fifth and final change. Victoria Pullover off. Kyra Cooney-Cross on for the last few minutes of stoppage time. It's another good addition in the summer, adding to that depth that Arsenal have. But stopped by Balti. And this might be the challenge for Chelsea because they have Champions League football. Next up, Hacken at Stamford Bridge on Thursday. Whereas Arsenal have the Continental Cup, something they will want to win. But where they could rotate players a little bit more freely. Fleming towards the back post. Fischl won it, but Zinsberger got there ahead of Kurt.
I don't think really any of the balls that have come into the box, no one's really got across Zinsberger. You know, she's just sort of every time she's there to just calmly collect the ball, really, with no one in and around her.
Fleming. That's a good ball. Find Wrighton. Maritz does well to stick to her. Some tremendous headwear. You're a fan of Christmas, aren't you, Jelly? Someone up to the commentary box.
I am a fan of Christmas, but I don't think my head would have fit around that tinsel either, to be honest with you. They don't make it large enough.
We might just have enough legs on it to reach Berger. Forward. Turning inside, finding Blackstinius, and now Lacasse. Wide.
And you know, she's a player as well, Lacasse, so she can come inside and she can put those balls in the back of the net. I mean, she's clearly well wide of the post, not even and close. Sometimes when you're up here, it looks like it's a lot closer than what it actually is, but you know, I think with Lacasse, she's got that. She can go on the outside and put the ball in the box. She can cut back inside and have a shot as well.
And the biggest feature of this game for Arsenal is that they have been tireless. They have not given Chelsea an inch.
Oh, I think I've been really impressed with Arsenal defensively today. You know, they've got behind the ball. Chelsea have broke at pace, they've countered at speed. But Arsenal have got bodies behind the ball, not allowed Chelsea to pick them off.
That's a good run from Fischl. Ruben Moy in the right place and also swoops it out to find Lacasse. Sliding in. Be thankful she missed the Chelsea player there. Fleming. Out to Lawrence. Blocked by McCabe. Lovely cross from Kirby for Kerr. It's just not happening today.
She could have that chance over and over again in any other game and she'd put that away, but sometimes it is just one of those days where nothing comes off for you whatsoever. She gets up, she gets a direction on it, but Zinsberger's in the right place.
Kerr and Kirby have linked up to score more goals than any other partnership in the WSL. I'm sure they will be back. Notching together again, but they've just not been at it today, Chelsea. We have seen this before. And usually they recover extremely well. Lovely ball from Ford down the line for Mornham up against Buchanan, and she'll take the corner.
Just a lot of Ruben Moy again there. Decision making on the ball, she does really well. She has great composure to get herself out of trouble.
Here's Balti, all the way back to the goalkeeper. All over. Christmas comes early for Arsenal. A big win, a statement win. They go level on points with Chelsea in the WSL table. A well-deserved victory for Jonas Edervall. Beth Mead, Amanda Innocent, and two goals for Alessia Russo. Kanarit scored for Chelsea, who were flat. A chastening afternoon for Chelsea. A confidence-boosting one for Arsenal. The champions beaten. well beaten by the Gunners. Consider the title race shaken up. Full time at the Emirates. Arsenal 4, Chelsea 1.
Thank you, Robin. Thank you, Julie. A statement win for Arsenal here at the Emirates. A record attendance for a WSL game. Alessia Russo, huge performance. Some big performances in that Arsenal team. Farrah Williams.
Yeah, I would agree, Alex. I think Russo was fantastic today for this Arsenal team. I think there was lots of Arsenal players that really turned up today, really put the pressure on Chelsea. And I think Chelsea, yes, they weren't an amazing, but I think that it was because of the way Arsenal was playing, the tempo, the intensity, the aggression. I think they dominated the game for the 90 minutes. And we've just seen the stats. The stats don't back that up, surprisingly, but it was a very dominant performance, Rachel, from Arsenal today.
It felt like a completely overwhelming and dominant performance from Arsenal. As you mentioned, the stats maybe don't paint that same picture, but it felt like that, you know, all this crowd here as well. The platform that it was given was, it gave it justice, the game, didn't it? It was such a heavyweight affair. Arsenal came out. They meant business from the opening seconds. And it seemed they were ever going to go on and win it.
A real statement from Arsenal, Farrah, which means the title race is wide open.
Yeah, and we heard Vivian Miedema speak before the game and said this is a must-win game if they are to be, you know, serious about challenging for the title at the end of the season. I think they were serious in their performance today. A massive 3 points, 4 goals. I think that obviously comes as a gap of confidence. So I think it's a huge win for them today.
What was it from Chelsea today? Why didn't they show up, Rachel?
Well, it was two heavyweight teams who came and wanted to imprint how they wanted to play, and Arsenal got their way. They did it to perfection. It was the clarity and the precision of everything that Arsenal did was far superior to Chelsea in the simple passes, in the decisive movements that they made, in the opportunity, the chances that they got. They took, I mean, we saw quite a few go astray right towards the end, but in those key moments, like Alessia Russo, had a brilliant, it was a reasonable chance, but convert by a world-class striker. And at the other end, just saw right at the end, like something, a bit of a sort of, you know, a good chance for her, but she didn't go in the back of the net. So there was the execution of everything that Arsenal did is what won the game today.
Yeah, and the Arsenal fans, you can see the celebrations, how happy they are. Emma Hayes, not too happy. Frustrated. We know how much of a winner she is.
Yeah, she'll be very frustrated, Alex, but I think she'll be frustrated with some of the decisions that led to some of the goals. I think the second goal in particular for Arsenal, she has an argument to say that there was a foul in the build-up to the corner that led to the goal, and also the penalty. There's an argument it wasn't a penalty, so I think she'll have something to say about that. But I think she's an honest manager, and her assessment won't be about the referee today. It'll be about her own players, because they really did underperform. They didn't turn up today. I wouldn't say they let Chelsea down, but they just wasn't at the races.
OK, well, let's show you how the WSL table stands at the moment. So that win from Arsenal today means they go level with Chelsea at the top of the table. Manchester City keeping pace, though, in third. West Ham United still rooted to the bottom of the WSL table. Let's take it back then. Let's show you some of the goals. Second half goal, 4-1, Alessia Russo, Farrah.
Alex, the penalty execution was fantastic from Russo, especially given the fact that the last penalty she took for Arsenal in the Champions League, she missed. But I don't think this is a penalty. In my decision, you can see Jess Carter here. She clearly wins the ball and takes it away from Beth Mead. And I'm really unsure as to the decision of the referee. Is she giving it against Jess Carter? If so, then does she get sent off for that? Or is she giving it against Berger and then she still would get a yellow card for that?
Yeah, she's giving it against Berger, in my opinion, but there's no cards being given. It's the wrong decision because Jess Carter plays the ball. End of. Decision over. But you look at the execution. Berger saving that unless it's right in the corner, right on the ground. Any elevation off the ground, Berger's going to save that because she gets the right way. And arguably could say justice would have been done, but it was Arsenal's day today.
But Farrah, like you just said, for Alessia Russo to have the confidence to take that penalty after such a big miss in a Champions League shows her strength of character.
Yeah, and I think she has huge character on it. I think she showed that when she went back to Manchester and Arsenal was booed for 90 minutes. That shows strength and character to come through that and perform the way she did. She hasn't been scoring for Arsenal as many goals as a striker or Arsenal fans would want her to, but her overall performance shows that she has character in this team. And then I think her two goals today, her first one in particular, I really like. And as you mentioned there, Alex, the character to step up. They are 3-1 up, so it becomes a little bit easier to take a penalty. But she will still be remembering that penalty miss in the Champions League that knocked them out.
OK, well, that was one penalty. But should have Chelsea had a penalty in that half, actually, Rachel?
No, I am nodding.
I think so. It's one that we're going to see. Barry used it straight away, said it's a penalty. It's off the ball incident. And it's a coming together right on the edge of the box. Frank Kirby just come on, bounces into the defender. Penalty?
There's no attempt whatsoever from Katie McCain to play any ball. The ball's not even been delivered. She has her clear intentions are to off-balance Frank Kirby, which she did. Her arm was high to the net. It's a penalty in my decision. An off-the-ball incident, only VAR or the assistant would have seen.
Katie McCain, let's talk about her character as well, because I know as that game's going on, you know, this is the side that frustrates me in her game.
Yeah, because Katie's a fantastic player, also a fantastic leader. We see how she leads the Irish team and how dominant she is, but she at times can, you know, do silly things. She got booked for kicking the ball away, so a yellow card. And then that off-the-ball incident that we've just seen, if it was to be seen, you know, she would have got sent off for it and left her team playing with 10 players, which you don't want to see.
I don't think we'll see the replay, but Lauren James was riding a tight sort of line between her reaction to a tackle. You know, these things with VAR, they'd be under the microscope. It'd be interesting to see whether they're going to get wiped out. And this is it right here. Lauren James, the whistle blows. And when you see the close-up of it, she leaves her foot in, drags it down on Balti's foot, and it would be a clear sending off.
Yeah, for sure. I would agree. I think that, you know, it's silly of Lauren James to do that given the state of the game. But again, it's a little bit of frustration from her.
OK, well, as you can see, Arsenal manager Jonas Idabel has joined us. Jonas, how proud of your players? How proud are you of that performance?
I think it's a really strong performance, especially the first half where I think we killed the game. I think this is the best we have played so far this season. I think we showed the potential that we know that we have had, but we haven't really played at that level. Mm-hmm. So it was really pleasing to see.
A nice early Christmas present for you.
Yeah, well, it's still two more games till Christmas. So it's like, even how great that was, it's another game on Wednesday, another game Saturday. So not Christmas yet.
Talk to me about the return of your players in terms of Beth Mead coming back into the team, making the impact that she has for you.
Yeah, and you can see how that's coming step by step as well. Like, we're coming from the Villa game where she's coming on and played 10 minutes, but she has an impact there. And now she can start the game, and we can see sort of the old Beth Mead where she counter presses. She's great in her 1v1 ability, and it's a joy to see her being back.
Go ahead, Jonas, no knee slide from you today, but how important in the context of the whole season could this win be?
I don't know. It's. I think for us, if I'm going to summarize in some ways to see, like when I play or when we played Chelsea here 2.5 seasons ago, and I was knee sliding after that game for that because that felt big. I think the only thing that matters now is the end position in the league. It's great that we won today. The performance really proud of. But let's not get carried away for it. It doesn't count for anything if we're not ready on Saturday against Tottenham.
Is that the message that you were saying in your team huddle?
Yes, very boring. I said enjoy yourself. It was really nice to see the performance. But the reality is we play Wednesday in the Conte Cup, and that's really important. So we need to be focused for that.
Does it feel like you've constantly got new signings coming back, as you've got Vivian Miedema also coming back now as well?
Yes, we have. And Leah Williamson is progressing really well as well. So she has started to come in lighter parts of team training now. So it's good. We're in a good momentum of getting players back.
Okay. How important was it to get your press right today against this Chelsea team and really disrupt them at the back?
I think that's the key when you're playing Chelsea, because once they start to swing you around from side to side and they're opening up these box pockets and they start running there with Lauren James, Frank Kirby, Jesse Fleming, I think then you're in big problem. So for us to make them more static and keeping them more to one side, it's a key thing, yeah.
I was saying at halftime, the only time they broke that press was when they got their goal. Other than that, I think the press was fantastic throughout.
Yeah, and I think at that time we probably should have fouled, to be honest.
And you were complaining about the yellow card and you want your players to foul you then.
Yeah, but to be honest with it, like it is what it is. But if that's 6-1 in yellow cards, yeah.
Okay, Jonas, thank you for joining us, because right now we're going to get over to Joe Curry, who's actually with the player of the match, Alessia Russo.
Well, Alessia, how do you begin to sum up a performance like that against a team like Chelsea at a packed-out Emirates?
Yeah, I don't think Sundays get much better than that. Great day. I think we started the game really well. We knew we wanted to come out, start positively, and the crowd got behind us from minute one. So, yeah, we worked hard in the week and we were ready for it.
Did it feel like a must-win game before you kicked off?
I think every game is a must-win game for us. We had a tough start to the season, but we knew where we want to go as a team. And yeah, the league is so competitive that you can't take one game off, especially against the team against Chelsea. So, yeah, it was a massive game and we knew we had to be at our A game.
Alessia, you are the Barclays Player of the Match. Congratulations on a fantastic afternoon.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Farah, just a quick one. How important is it that the title race is open?
I think it's exciting for the neutral. We don't want teams like Chelsea to dominate for as long as they have. They've won the title 4 years on the bounce now. So it is important the likes of Manchester City and Arsenal keep that pressure on Chelsea and make it exciting till the end of the season for sure.
OK, well, Rachel, Farah, thank you for joining me. Do join us next week as it's Manchester United taking on Liverpool. And just before we say goodbye to all the women in football, in front of the camera, behind it, to the players on the pitch, to everyone that attends game, keep being the role models that you can continue to be, to all those young girls that are told no, you can't. Football is a better place with us all in it. Goodbye.
Biggest game in the WSL season so far. Is there an effort? Yes, there is! There's more than that. There's a goal! Cannon Reid in at the near post. It's there! Arsenal back in front. Russo! 3-1! Penalty to Arsenal. Pressure moment for Alessia Russo. Absolutely clinical. Christmas comes early for Arsenal. They go level on points with Chelsea.